About 20 or 25 minutes outside of beautiful downtown Columbus, Ohio, sits the suburb of Groveport. This is a story of the fourth high school in the Groveport-Madison School District's history. As the district has evolved, this building has also been our freshman school, a junior high, and it's currently Groveport-Madison Middle School Central. Yeah, for the longest time, it was just a freshman school, which made it pretty unique because the faculty's sole mission in this building was to teach freshmen. You didn't go to high school until you were a sophomore back then. Not many other school districts nearby had the same infrastructure. In order to understand how people felt about going to this building, no matter which grade they were in when they went to it, we have to track this thing from the beginning.
Groveport-Madison High School class of 1974. I am the one responsible for getting Groveport School, or also known as Groveport Elementary, and what I call the old high school next door, both on the National Register of Historic Places. Both buildings are on the National Register because of their unique nature. Groveport Elementary, other than just its outside beautiful design, also was unique because it had a separate gym and a separate auditorium. And schools back in that era in the 20s usually combined the gym and auditorium into one facility. So this made the Groveport School stand out amongst other schools in the area. The building next door was called the Annex at the time it was built in the 50s. It was built in three stages. The gym in 52 used to stand there all by itself. Good golly, Miss Marley, sure like the ball. And if you go down a certain couple of hallways, you can tell it's got outside brick from when it used to be a standalone building. It also had the cafeteria built in 2 years later, and then 2 years after that, the classrooms were added to it. Because of the unique nature of how it was built in three stages, the building fell under the scope of the National Register because it's an unusual building. There's some hallways that kind of lead to nowhere, some stairways that one time used to lead to nowhere. There's some interesting pastel colored tile in the building that you just didn't see anywhere else. It just made for a unique building. And having the two coupled together with the walkway essentially makes both buildings one building. And therefore, they're both on a National Register. If you go out in front of the buildings, you can see the plaques on both of them, and they're there for our history.
Amen to that, and thank you for getting that done, Rick.
Oh, no problem.
Hi, my name is Kim Woods, and I am a proud graduate of the Groveport-Madison High School class of 1987. I attended the Groveport Freshman Building in the year of 1984, and it was a wonderful and unique experience in that in those years, the district combined our graduating class for the first time by bringing together the eighth grade classes from Groveport Middle North and Groveport Middle South. I have a distinct and vivid memory that year that I put my name on the ballot for class president, and I remember standing in that auditorium in front of all of my classmates giving that speech, thinking, I sure hope, as my hands are shaken, that they don't know how nervous I really am. I'm really proud that I graduated from that district, and I'm proud of the year that I spent in that freshman building.
Hi, my name is John Jennings, class of 1995. My favorite part of the freshman building was meeting all the kids from middle school north, where north meets south. A lot of the kids, even though we lived within miles of each other, we had never met, and it made it very interesting.
Do you have a favorite teacher? Do you recall a favorite teacher in the building?
I would have to say my favorite teacher at the freshman school is probably Gary Shade.
Any particular reason why?
He played golf, so we had that in common. Absolutely.
And a favorite part of the building?
I can't help but think the gymnasium, since it was carpeted at that time. I mean, you didn't see many gyms that had carpet, so that was definitely different, something you'll never forget.
Did you get any rug burns?
Multiple.
But it was worth it, right?
Absolutely.
Freshman gym class was in here, along with freshman basketball, volleyball, wrestling. All the wrestling meets were held in here. Plays were actually held up there on the stage. So this is kind of one of those gymatorium rooms. And you can see there's bleachers up on the stage as well. So they had four bleachers on both sides. They had bleachers on both balconies, and they had bleachers up on the stage. So when this gym first opened way back in the 50s, it was the largest gym in Franklin County. So they used to have all kinds of regional county tournaments right here in this gym because it could hold more fans than anyone else. I mean, look at it. Swing your partner round and round, and then the night is going down. One more shot, another round, and then the night is going down. Swing your partner round and round.
Fellow cruisers, my name is Jerry Roof. I graduated in 1957 from Groveport, and my favorite part of going to school was all sports.
What was your favorite sport?
Baseball was my favorite sport.
Now, I was looking at your senior yearbook, and it mentioned that you were a four-sport star, that you played football, basketball, and in the spring, you doubled up and actually played baseball and golf at the exact same time.
Yes, I did.
I was looking at the schedule, Jerry, and it looked like you were literally playing a baseball game on Monday, and you had a golf match on Tuesday.
That's correct, I did.
And then another baseball game on Wednesday, and another golf match on Thursday.
We had a full schedule.
name's Kyle Jennings. I'm in the class of 2022. I went to the freshman school when it was called Middle School Central. My favorite teacher was Mr. Pompey. He taught American history in eighth grade. He took us on the DC trip, and he was just the best teacher I've had all throughout my high school or my school career so far.
Jackie Smith Jovic from Groveport class of a very long time ago. My favorite part of the freshman school was laying the foundation for lifelong friendships. It was a special place to really get to know your freshman classmates before heading to the big high school with all of the upperclassmen. Now, every year I get together with three of my old teammates from the cheerleading squad to catch up and celebrate what's happening in our lives. We've maintained our friendship for decades, and that bond between the four of us all started at the Groveport freshman school.
Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girl said you hallelujah. Girl said you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Saturday night and we in the spot.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Hey y'all, Zach Clary, class of 2002, Groveport student, kindergarten through high school. Man, the freshman building. So many memories, but I guess the two that really come to mind are, one, actually go back to when I was in the elementary school and sharing that cafeteria every day. I remember going over there as a first and second, third grader and all that, and seeing all the high school kids through those double doors on the other side. I just remember thinking to myself, wow, like, you know, how old they were, how big they were, and, you know, never thought I'd be that age. Then before you know it, I'm the ones on the other side of that door, seeing the other kids coming in and eating their lunch who were in the same shoes I was many years before. Also, kind of the ability to grow up playing sports in Groveport. Got to play with a lot of other kids from the Groveport schools, and especially in baseball. And it was really neat kind of merging in North and South. I went to middle school South, but so many other kids that I grew up playing sports with going to middle school North. So not only did we go to a new school in the freshman building, but it was nice kind of walking in and knowing some of those people from before. A lot of memories, a great place, and it was a really neat experience being able to come together before we went to the big high school with everyone else.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, would you capture it? Just let it slip.
You better lose this hell. The music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose this count in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow.
Hi, I'm Deanna Jennings, and I'm class of 1995 at Groveport Madison High School. I liked the freshman school because it was different. You were coming in. I was from the more of the city type part of Groveport, so it was different to come into the actual town of Groveport. It was very unique, and I really hadn't visited that side of Groveport until I became a student at the freshman school. I would have to say that probably my favorite class in when I was a freshman was probably chemistry, because it was the first time that you really got to have a chemistry class. So I do remember going into the school and making a left-hand turn and going into chemistry class, and it was kind of cool because we'd never experienced anything like that before.
Teacher, teacher, can you teach me? Can you tell me all I need?
Teacher, teacher, can you teach me? Can you tell everyone. My name is Tom Stevenson. I'm a Groveport graduate, class of 1963. The building behind me, I started there in 1960, and we graduated in 1963. I'm happy to say that my mom, my dad, my brother, his wife, my niece and nephew, and many aunts and uncles all graduated from the old elementary school you're going to see very soon. We are excited to do this video and hope that the alumni understand how important it is to have something to rely on and something history will never replace.
Now, Tom, while you were going here to what was then the high school here in Groveport, which became the freshman building for a lot of us here, do you recall a favorite teacher, a favorite instructor of yours?
It was our physical education teacher, Bob Carter. And he was also our basketball coach, and he was an assistant football coach. And Bob helped all of us become better citizens. He had to use some discipline on us every once in a while because we all weren't perfect angels.
Now, we do have to tell everyone that eventually you became the principal of this building right here behind you.
I lived on Cherry Street and grew up at 437 Cherry Street. Also living on Cherry Street was Mr. Ed Rary. Obviously that name is very familiar and famous for the town of Groveport. Ed was a principal at Gahanna Lincoln Elementary School, and I always liked what he did and his thoughts, so I tried to emulate him. Fortunately, I was an assistant principal at Middle School South, and a job came open at Groveport Elementary. In 1979, I started there, and I finished in the year of 2000.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. Everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home. You're like a dream come true. But if by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you're so to know. You look like a movie, you sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young.
There's still one more important piece of this school's puzzle to put together for you. There was no way I was going to forget this, because not only was it my favorite part of the freshman school experience, but you can't talk about the history of this building without including this.